Banner posters on my wall.
Oh my God, it's real. It,
right.
Well, me personally, I grew up in hip hop, being in the Bronx. So I recall watching, you know, Grandmaster Flash and Melly Mel and them playing softball, basketball in the park. Love Bug Starsky was from my neighborhood. Fantastic Five, Little Ike C, Ruby D was from my neighborhood. Mr. Ness lived right next door to him. My brother was a crate boy for Grandmaster Flash, carrying the crates.
And On the Way Up was there too.
So, that's my ringtone, so I grew up in hip hop. Like, I watched it go from The Hustle, the Bee Gees, to hip hop. To be real, got to be real. To be real.
There's like 85 records that came out in 79, 80 with that as their beat.
While you party down, y'all can shock the house. Get down, rock, shock the house.
Young ladies make the world go round the way they look and walk. Well, the fellas say they could live without them, but that's a lot of talk.
We love the beat, y'all. The beat, y'all. That bump up the beat, y'all. Now, if you're dancing on the floor, sitting in the seat, or rocking to the beat, say you want the beat. We got
to be real was the best shit ever.
Yeah.
And a heartbeat, boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom,
boom. We're gonna meet you in the rooftop. Oh,
so it was like,
I'm put almost 40, 39. Oh, so, yeah.
And you know about this.
Because it's homework.
Not S-H-A-N. I'm the free man. Where your show's at? I took you out in 86 and the whole world knows that. For 30 years, nigga, you ain't spitting no rap. Queensbridge hates your ass. You can't go back.
See, he was going up against the biggest rap crew ever, and they had a monopoly because they had Mr. Magic, who ran BLS, who was only playing the Juice Crew. So now you say it was him against MC Shan, Shantae, Roxanne. It was Coogee Rap. It was Craig G. It was Master Ace. It was Big Daddy Kane. It was Biz Markie. It was Mr. Magic. This was the Coca-Cola or Pepsi of rap. Like, be clear, every last one of them niggas was like Coogee Rap. They all was platinum. The whole, you don't know none of these niggas I'm talking about, right, Rem? Yo, it was like 10 of them. And that chick Roxanne Shantae, she was cold as fuck. You need to listen
personally.
To
her. I know her.
She was dead nice at the time. I'm Shantae. Rhymes, chippy rhymes are fresh. Nigga, I'm Shantae. Like, yo. Yeah. So he was going up the most amazing powers that be with one single. So even me, the number one, to this day, that's my idol.
Yeah.
The number one KRS-One fan. No way on earth was he going to win. Like, no way on earth was he going to beat these guys. Like, it's in. You know the people I tell you about, Rem, to ignore?
Yes.
You know the people that... No. Well, he was they. I know. Yo, Rem, he was they. And came out of nowhere and demolished niggas. So at the time, I never even heard of reggae music. I never heard reggae, Jamaican music, nothing like that. So and then I remember it was cold as fuck. And I had a Walkman on, and I'm just going to visit my man in the back of the building. And Red Alert is like, brand new answer, this record to the Juice Crew, KRS-One. So I'm like, I'm walking, I'm like, oh shit, gotta hear it. But I'm like, it's no hope. No hope. Like, you know,
whoever
like,
this is.
There's no way he's gonna win. Right? That's like taking Jay-Z, Nas, 50 Cent, Fat Joe, line them all up. That was the crew. That's who he was going against. And that shit came on. Boom, 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 boom. That shit came on. He said, the bridge is over, the bridge is over. The bridge is over, the bridge is over. Hey, hey, the bridge is over. I was like, yo, Ram. It was like a niggas on a canoe in an ocean. Like, the flow he was kicking was like being on a canoe. We never heard it, Ram, ever in the history of rap music. It was like, he was like, the bridge is over, the bridge is over. It was like being stuck like this or this. Well, we're coming down the sound with the stiffer sensei. Down with the sound called BDP. Well, you can't sound like Shannon or the one Marley. And then Rasta Sante is only good for steady fucking. Then I was like, ah! Start running around the So, I'm running. It was brick. It was like a below zero day. I'm running. Through the whole project. Nobody can hear it though. It's not summer. And then, yo! Like, could not believe it.
He killed it.
And that was a one listen. The one time I heard that, I knew the bridge is over. The bridge is over. Ba-da-ba-ba. That was it. And he always said, you know what KRS-One said? Rem?
What?
Legendary KRS-One who toppled
the whole empire.
You know what he said?
What?
They lost when they paid attention to me. They should have never even listened to me or answered. That's his bar of a lifetime, KRS-One. Yes. When you analyze his career, he said, had they never responded to me or ever listened to me, I would have no career.
That's right.
It would have just fell on deaf ears and that would have been that.
That's it. That's what people
That's why you can't listen to
You can't listen to bullshit. You gotta keep it.